Question number 49, wheel is starting from rest, means omega 1 is equal to 0, is asking theta, theta is equal to, uniformly alpha is given, theta is equal to omega 1 t plus half alpha t square. So time is given 5 seconds, 0, theta is equal to 0 plus angular velocity is 10 radians, half into 10 into time is 5 seconds. 5 square, this is answer. Next, question number 50, when body is floating, total mass is balanced by buoyancy force. So this is volume of the body into density of body into g is equal to volume of the body inside liquid into density of liquid into g. So here density of ice is given 0.9. what fraction of the volume of iceberg is, what fraction of it is submerged, means is asking volume inside by volume of the body, is asking volume inside by volume of the body is equal to density of the body by density of liquid. This is the answer. What fraction is present? Then take the density of water there, you will get the answer. The value of acceleration due to gravity at a height of 10 km from surface of earth is x. At what depth inside the earth the value of acceleration due to gravity has the same value x? If this is also very simple question. Acceleration due to gravity at height h is equal to gh is equal to g into r square by r plus h whole square. And gd is equal to g into 1 minus d by r, where d is the depth. Now you have to find d, r value, r value is 6400, r plus h value is given 10 kilometers, then you have to find d value you will get nearly 10 kilometers means nearly you will get 5, because this you convert into short form, 1 minus 2h by r. This gh you can write g into 1 minus 2h by r if h is very small. So when both are equal means g into 1 minus d by r, these two must be equal means 2h must be equal to d, 2h must be equal to d means 20 kilometers. That will be the answer. Young's modulus of a perfect rigid body, this I told several times in our class, it is infinity. Certain amount of heat energy, fraction of heat energy converted into work is 1 minus 1 by gamma, where gamma is the ratio of specific heats. Fraction of heat energy converted is equal to 1 minus 1 by gamma, that is 1 minus 1 by gamma. Next question, what is asking? A certain amount of heat energy is supplied to a monatomic ideal gas which expands at constant pressure. What fraction of heat energy is converted into heat? So 1 minus 1 by gamma, gamma value of monatomic gas, you substitute gamma value of monatomic gas, you will get the answer. 5 by 3 if you substitute, you will get. Next, a sphere, cube and a thin circular plate, all of same material and same mass, initially heated to same high temperature, are allowed to cool down under similar condition. Plate will cool fast, sphere will cool slow, because heat flow is directly proportional to area of cross section. Area of cross section. So if area of cross section is more, for a given volume, sphere will have less area of cross section. In adiabatic expansion temperature decreases, so therefore PV is equal to nRT. Temperature decreases means the product of PV also decreases. Indirectly is asking what happens to temperature. Adiabatic expansion cools down, where adiabatic compression heats. Temperature will increase. Next, a tray of mass, question number 57. Here two springs are present. You can calculate the total spring constant, that is time period is equal to 2 pi under root of m by k. From this you can write k is equal to 4 pi square m by t square. Calculate k and divide by 2, you will get the answer. M value is given 12, divide by 2, you will get exactly k is equal to, afterwards you have to divide by 2, because two springs are there, you will get 105. Next, a train is whistling at constant frequency. So when it is approaching towards you, that frequency increases, reaches the peak value. When it is going back, frequency decreases. Therefore, it is answer is B. Next, a uniform thin wire has a uniform charge density. Lambda is given. This is Gauss first application. Electric field is equal to lambda by 2 pi r. R is given as 20. Lambda is given as 1 by 4. You just substitute, you will get the answer. Infinitely long thin straight wire has a uniform charge density of 1.4 into 10 power minus 2 per centimeter. What is the magnitude of electric field at a distance of 20 centimeter from the axis of the wire? So, electric field is equal to lambda by 2 pi r. This is from first application of Gauss. So, next question number 59. A charge is kept at the corner. When a charge is kept at the corner, the contribution of that charge to 1 cube, it is only q by 8. It is there in your chemistry also. If a charge is kept at corner, it is contribution to that cube is q by 8. And each corner, from each corner, 3 surfaces will come. So q by 8 by 3 is the q by 8 by 3 epsilon naught will be answer. That is q by 24 epsilon naught. The electric field lines of left half has twice the separation on those on the right half. If the magnitude of field at A, see, when electric field lines are closer, electric field intensity is more. So at A it is 40, means at B it is definitely 20, because exactly separation is half. So 20 into 20 mu c will be the answer. 20 into 20 mu c will be the answer. 20 into 20 mu c. So this is the explanation of all your questions which has appeared in today's exam. And at the last, I will place the key paper of C1. Just pause the video and you will watch it, and you can calculate your marks. So,